What are you picking up?
Well, yes, that is the big breaking news. And as CNBC TV 18 has reported, the board of Aditya Birla Nuvo has approved a composite scheme of restructuring between Grasim as well as Aditya Birla Nuvo. The first flash that is coming in that Aditya Birla Nuvo will be merged into Grasim. Thereafter, the financial business of Aditya Birla Nuvo will be demerged and that will become a separate entity. So this is going to be a two-stage restructuring. One part of it will entail a demerging of the financial services business into a separate entity. I'm not too sure right now if they plan to keep it listed. I guess it will, considering how the market is valuing finance companies right now. And the second part of it is that the rest of the business of Aditya Birla Nuvo, which is a combination of textile, rayon, you know, etc., will get merged into Grasim. So that is exactly what CNBC TV 18 has been reporting for the last 2 days. And that's the mega restructuring announced by the Birla Group. Varinder is through the press release which has just been announced. Varinder, your initial reaction?
Well, to be honest, I'm just trying to understand what they're saying, because, you know, as you said, it's a two-way restructuring what the company has announced. And, you know, Aditya Birla Nuvo has three businesses, okay, in the financial services space. One is a Birla Sun Asset Management, one is Birla Sun Life Insurance, and the third one is, you know, Aditya AB Financial Services. And I think what the company is talking now is Aditya Birla Financial Services. That's the one the company is talking about. It's a business which has assets under management of nearly 25,000 crore. And this is what they're saying, that they have a scheme of arrangement between the company, that is AB Nuvo, its wholly owned subsidiary AB Aditya Birla Financial Services, and Grasim Industries. Well, I'm trying to understand, well, I think nowhere they have mentioned that there could be demerger of the non-financial services business of Aditya Birla Nuvo. If I'm right in understanding what the company is saying, they are saying that it will be a two-stage process. The first one will be the scheme of arrangement between the Aditya Birla Financial Services, and then the entire company will be merged into Grasim. So what we need to understand is that whether there is any demerger first taking place or not.
I think first it's a merger of Aditya Birla Nuvo and Grasim, and from the merged entity they will be demerging the financial services business, because very clearly in the press release they're saying the scheme provides for the merger of Aditya Birla Nuvo with Grasim, and post said merger, the demerger of the financial services business from the amalgamated Grasim into Aditya Birla, you know, financial services, and consequent listing of the financial business. Then you merge the two entities, AB Nuvo and Grasim, and from the merged entity you take out the financial business and list it separately. But that's what it appears, you know, prima facie.
Well, now, you know, clearly this will not be taken well by the Grasim shareholders, as we have been discussing you know, throughout the day since last yesterday also. If I have to just, you know, consider and think about what will the merged entity look like, you know, after all this process happens, then there will be two entities which will be left over. One will be Grasim will have what they have right now, plus they will have the, you know, non-financial services business of Aditya Birla Nuvo. And that will mean that this idea stake what AB Nuvo holds will be transferred to Grasim.
Yes.
And that will mean a, you know, more holding company discount to idea shareholders, which Grasim will never like it. If you have to think about what will be financial services business of this company, financial services business of course will include life insurance, assets under management, AMC business, and other businesses what they have. Now I can go in terms of valuation what these companies will be having, but I'm sure we have some guests.
Yeah, we have Sanjeev Vaseen, who are the executive vice president, who joins us of IIFL. Hi Sanjeev, thanks so much for joining in today. The details are out now. We know that AB Nuvo as well as Grasim, there'll be a merger, and that will be followed by a demerger. What's your initial take on this announcement?
Yeah, so it's you know, it's now official. What the rumor was that the debt of the holding of Idea now comes under the new basket of Grasim.
Right.
And like Varinder was pointing out, it seems all the financial services will be merged. It will just be the holding company of Idea, which was previously held by AB Nuvo. So, you know, about 6 months back, they demerged their whole lifestyle business, which was also made a separate entity, and now the financial services is also being hived out.
Right.
So Grasim will become the holding company not only of UltraTech but also of Idea. And the pessimism is that why would a manufacturing unit have to come into telecom and the other variables? You've done away with the financial, but why the telecom burden coming under one roof? It is being priced in as a negative. And I think the market will also, you know, now it's official, this is what is taking place.
You know, we're also waiting for if some swap issue comes, because that will be also important. You know, I can tell you that this will not be taken positively by anyone if they are Grasim shareholders.
Yes.
And I will also be amazed at one more thing, that Grasim, if you just see the, you know, shareholding pattern, I think promoters own nearly 37% stake.
Okay.
And the remaining is owned by non-promoters. Now, why this is important is because, you know, when it comes to that, the shareholders have
majority
to vote.
Of the minority.
Exactly. You know, the minorities are owning majority in Grasim, you know, so this will not be a small process. This will take an elongated time.
Okay, so as of now, what we know is that a mega restructuring has been announced in the Aditya Birla Group. As CNBC TV 18 has been reporting, Aditya Birla Nuvo will be merged into Grasim. From the merged entity, the financial services business will be separated out and listed. What we don't know right now is the swap ratio between AB Nuvo as well as Grasim. So Grasim, as our experts have been saying, it will be negative. The structure becomes complex. Their holding in Idea goes up from the current 5% to almost 28%. But Kritika's right there where the action is. And Kritika, you want to add in something? Okay, we'll come back to Kritika, but Prashant Nair is also joining in. Prashant, you want to throw in your perspective?
You know, as Varinder has been saying, I think life of Grasim becomes more complicated. It was a clean company, right? I mean, it only had the VSF business, the standalone business, which people were starting to understand over the last couple of years. Because Grasim, remember, over the last decade or so has undergone, it's been always been at the crux of some change.
Yeah.
But now, finally, it was starting to get understood by analysts. And then it had the 60% stake in Ultratech,
yeah.
which is the largest cement company. So as I see it, there is no real upside for Grasim shareholders here. They could be downside, could be. But there is no upside here. I think that's the way to kind of look at this deal from a Grasim perspective.
Yeah.
You know, the financial services business being demerged into Aditya Birla Financial Services later, after the merger of AB Nuvo with Grasim, I think that would be, before that, I think we will see the promoter sell some stake in the financial services business to realize a value. You know, I think, so there are two aspects to it. One,
similar to what we happened with, I think,
Max
and when they sold to,
I mean, you know, because right now AB Nuvo has too many things.
Mm.
It's got financial services, which is right now the fastest. Think about the Aditya Birla Group. The brick and mortar businesses have not been doing well for a while now. The financial services business have been doing phenomenally well.
Mm.
Where are they placed? They are situated in Aditya Birla Nuvo. To realize the full value, you have to give you know, investors a clean play. So I think that purpose is solved if you list it separately. And then the point about Idea, Rima, that you've been making as well, the way to do it is essentially maybe a rights issue, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you, in Grasim, Idea announces a rights issue, Grasim holding now 30%, close to 30% in Idea,
yeah.
Subscribes to the issue, the cash goes into Idea and Idea uses it for whatever, spectrum bidding or whatever. I mean, you know, these are all things that we are kind of speculating about, but these seem probable. I mean, they're not out of the ordinary, that they can't happen. We'll have to, of course, wait for this to happen. But one thing is very clear, that the financial services value, I mean, trying to get a clean value for the financial services business,
is
that would
positive.
Be the first aim for doing this. I mean, that would be step one. And then Idea comes later.
You know, Prashant, just want to add on that, because prior to this, it was 23% stake that AB Nuvo held in Idea. Grasim has around 5% stake. It goes to around 28%. I've been ringing the phone lines. I've been talking to a lot of tax experts now. We have INDAS that's come about. Will that entity have to account for the debt that's in the books? It's around 35,000 crores in Idea's books.
Mm-hmm.
So this merged entity, will they have to account for that debt? If that's the case, then we'll have closer to around 8 to around 10,000 crores that will have to be accounted. There's no clarity yet on this.
Okay.
But as per the new guidelines, that could be a possibility. If that's the case, currently you have Grasim with a debt of what? 3,000-4,000 crores. Suddenly it goes up by another 10,000 crores if that is the case. So that is
Does it seem likely, Nigel? That seems a little...
it's not totally out of the whack, because
okay.
I've made at least 5 to 10 calls in the last few minutes. Even tax experts were wondering whether or not this is possible, because it's not a small part. It's not.
You know, then, if that is the case,
that's
if that were to be
negative
true,
for Grasim.
Then you, I mean, then you know, because this transaction would be, this is a material transaction. This would have to be approved at the AGM.
That's true.
Majority of the minority shareholders will have to say yes to this transaction.
Right.
If so, I mean, I think this is an important point that you're making, and I think we should get some experts, some
tax experts
to
yeah.
kind of clarify this. But if this were to be true, I think you'd see some back and forth. I mean, some pushing back before. You know, the minorities say yes, because at this point, the debt has no bearing on the holding company.
Exactly.
But if, as you're saying,
if that's the
straight
case,
away 10,000 crores, I think that's going to be a big
blow. If Idea's debt is 35,000 crores.
It's 37,500 crores.
Even without that, the point I've been making is there is no upside for Grasim here. There could be downside. Right. How much of the downside? That depends. I mean, if the tax, you bring in the tax angle, then the downside becomes pretty large, right? Yeah, I mean, it becomes complicated.
Okay, just stay on. We'll go across to Kritika. She's right at, you know, where the action is. Kritika, you've told us about this story first. You broke it 2-3 days ago. Tell us more what you're picking up.
So, you know, the most of the details in terms of how exactly or what exactly is happening is yet to come out. But what we do know, so see, basically there were two options for them. There was the option of demerging the non-financial services business and merging that into Grasim and AB Nova holding just financial services. And the second option is what they have opted for, which is basically to keep all the non-financial services businesses within AB Novo and merge that with Grasim. The reason for that could be purely to give better value. We've been talking to people, and of course many analysts have been on the channel. Tulsiyan was on the channel earlier today talking about how this would be a negative for Grasim. But in a broader sense, what, you know, my sources within Birla have been saying is that in the long term, this fits their strategy. The point right now is, and yes, there will be pros and cons over here. The point is to create a simpler vertical, create a non-financial services business and a separate financial services company. You know, while yes, there is a focus on Idea, what we haven't looked at is the fact that Aditya Birla Group now wants to delve very significantly into the financial services space, and that is why instead of leaving AB Novo with just financial services, they have gone ahead and demerged the entire financial services business into a separate entity, and that will be later listed on the stock exchanges. The timeline will be at least a year for everything in terms of approvals to go through. But yes,
Kritika, do we know how the merger, the technicalities of the merger itself? I mean, first of all, congratulations. I mean, you've been on this for the last 2 days. But in terms of how this is actually going to get done, merging the first stage, Novo with Grasim, I mean, how is this getting done?
So we know we don't have the swap ratio, and that will be very crucial, Prashant. And we've been guessing exactly how this will work out. Once we have the swap ratio, we can put numbers to it. But in the first step, the sense I get and from what I hear over here as well, in the first step, in a sense, they will remove and carve out the financial services vertical into a separate entity. That will be formed. The details will be formed. The management, etc., will be decided. That's the
Kritika,
first step.
I think the release...
Step, they will.
No, but, Prashant and Kritika, I think that has been made very clear in the release, okay?
That they're merging first and then they're taking out the financial services business.
And that's listed separately.
I mean, I think there was a fair bit of talk that they're going to take out the financial services business, the non-financial services part, and then merge with Grasim. I think that's been made clear.
No, but they are
both companies come together, and then financial services goes out into what is called ABFSL.
Which step happens first? Eventually, you're going to realize the same goal.
Yeah.
So does it matter whether they demerge first and then merge?
I think
merge
we have Mr. Tulsiyan also, and it'll be important to get his comment as well on this issue. Mr. Tulsiyan, what is your first reaction on this, sir?
See, Varinda, let me first explain. If you read the note 6 of Aditya Birla Nuvo result Q1, it clearly says that entire Aditya Birla Nuvo will get merged into the Grasim, and then thereafter the financial services business will get demerged. So I don't think that there is any confusion in terms of the modus operandi from here on. We need not even wait for the results. Note 6 to the Q1 numbers of Aditya Birla Nuvo is sufficient and explaining very correctly. So what will happen, what I've understood here, that entire Aditya Birla Nuvo will get merged into the Grasim, and then from that merged entity, that enlarged one, you know, the merger of, or the merged entity of AB Nuvo and Grasim, then from that the financial services business will get carved out. So if I just, I've just made a rough calculation, if I just go by the, because if you see whenever the swap ratios have all decided, they have all happened on the market price, prevailing market price. And if I go by that analogy, then, you know, I expect that 3-1. That means for every 3 shares held of the Aditya Birla Nuvo, we'll get 1 share of Grasim. And let me just point out here quickly, as a passing reference, if you see the Aditya Birla Nuvo shares have risen by about 55-60% in this last 45 days, which is really unheard of. And what I can only presume that why this entire exercise is being done, to increase the promoter stake of to increase the promoter stake in the merged entity to about 40%. Because if you take now, our promoters are having 58% in Aditya Birla Nuo. Now, we all know that the Grasim is the flagship company in which the promoters are just holding 31.28%. So if I go on the presumption that the swap ratio will be one share of Grasim for every three shares held of Aditya Birla Nuo, this is just an assumption, because we since know the modalities, there is no confusion. We can always, you know, take any hypothetical, whether it is 2.9 or 3.1, doesn't make any difference. Take 3 as a swap ratio. So in that event, the promoter stake will rise to 40%. The equity of the Grasim will rise from 100 crore to about 137, from 94 crore to about 137 crore. So I think, and what will happen, the whole debt of 35,000 crore of Aditya Birla Nuo will get passed on or will get assumed by the Grasim industry. So now, going forward, Grasim, which used to be a very clean company, now will have brick and mortar business of fertilizer, insulator, rayon, and all sort of things with a debt of about 35,000 crore on the standalone basis. On a consolidated basis, debt could be as high as 50,000.
Sinsin, we had one question. Post-consolidation, Grasim as well as Aditya Birla Nuo will have close to about 28% stake in Idea. Idea has a debt of 37,500 crore rupees. So the question Nigel has raised is, according to the new accounting standards, will Grasim and Aditya Birla Nuo, the merged entity, also have to account for some portion of the debt of Idea Cellular on account of its holding of 28%?
See, Reema, that point will always be there. They have to account for under the new accounting policies also. But I don't think that is a relevant and material point here. Because as I've been saying earlier also, because there are two or three objectives. The one objective which I have inferred from this merger is to increase the promoter shareholding. Because if you see for the last maybe 3 to 5 years, the motto of the group is to increase the promoter holding in each company. Yeah. We all know that the promoter holding in Idea is 42-43%. In Grasim, it is the least. While in Grasim, it is 31.28%. While which is the most precious company, if you really ask me, on a standalone basis, on a very clean balance sheet, and that too with
takes the promoter into promoter holding. Prashant here, this takes the promoter holding in Grasim to it would increase it substantially, right? Closer to 40%.
Prashant, promoter stake in the merged entity will
in the rise merged to entity 40%. In the merged entity, yes, in the merged entity.
That's what I said. 40%. That it will rise to 40%, and Grasim equity will rise to 137 crore.
Right.
Yes,
Mr. Tulsian, I just want to ask you one quick question. You know, in the last 6 months, the promoters have increased stake in both Grasim as well as Aditya Birla Nuo. They have been doing creeping. Does that clause that 6 months you cannot do anything in both the two companies before you announce this merger, does SEBI have a say in this? Because promoters, they have creeped maybe around 0.5%, 1% in the last 6 months. So is that cooling off period valid, or have they gone according to the rules?
See, if you really ask me, I don't think that they can, in fact, you know, have these kind of increase. And thereby, I'm not honestly aware about the 6 months cooling period. You know, what is the preceding time by which they should not have increased the stake. But my point is that, you know, this information of the merger of or whatever restructuring which we have seen today has been in the street for last maybe 1 month. And we have seen 55% in...
Mr. Tulsian, let us interrupt you. The swap ratio is out. For 100 shares of Nuo, shareholders will be getting 30 shares of Grasim.
That is
so that
one.
Is
that's the same one ratio. Three it's to a market one price ratio, which is there.
Yeah, that is the 3.3.
That is exactly what Mr. Tulsian was also mentioning. Okay, so it has come exactly at what the market closing price of both the shares is. Mr. Tulsian, after knowing this ratio 3:1, what is your reaction on the stock prices tomorrow in the morning?
See, again, I think that this the worst affected will be the Grasim, because I don't think that Grasim shareholders will really tolerate that, because enough is enough. When 5 years back, the whole restructuring of the cement business has happened, there was clear, I remember, you know, at that time, there was clear indications from the management that it will be seen very value accretive, very, and all those usual riders and all that, and people have really been very dissatisfied, the Grasim shareholder. And I think having dumped the entire thing and with 35,000 crore debt getting assumed by Grasim with the business, like, you know, now let me just quickly go through the performance of the Aditya Birla Nuo textile EBIT. I'm referring Q1 of FY17. Textile EBIT 32 crore against 47 crore. Agri 45 crore against 53 crore. This insurance 15 crore against 22 crore. Financial services 14 crore against this one. almost zero. So what my point is that all the brick and mortar business have been showing a, and Rayon 63 crore, only Rayon has shown a significant improvement in the financial performance. So what my point is that your insulator and fertilizer business, both are seen a drag or are having no growth potential at all, which are now going into the Grasim. So I don't think that Grasim shareholders are going to get take this accept this very, very pleasantly. And one has to really understand the institutional investors' reaction, how they react to this whole.
Sir, do you think you know, there will be huge objection by the minority shareholders, because Grasim, the promoters own, as you said, 32% stake in the company, and the minority are the majority in this case. Do you think that this will even pass, considering, you know, this this is a kind of deal which no one will like?
See, Varinder, if you really ask me, this will be the acid test of the institutional investor. I remember when the Gujarat plant by Maruti was created, I was the lone voice which has supported that, while the entire, in fact, there was a show on CNBC Awaaz where they asked me, 100% of the advisors are saying this is negative. If they they have come with such a unanimous voice for Maruti, which was not seen an anti move at all, so I in fact would be willing to see the what is the wise counsel prevail on all these institutional investors, whether they strongly object this or whether they coolly accept it, because it is very difficult for me to comment. But I can only say that I have not seen the seen such a prejudicially negative interest negative move for the against the minority shareholder by any promoter.
You know, let's discuss the swap ratio in greater detail. Yes, it's come in line with what the market was anticipating at 1:3. But if you take three, you know, at the current swap ratio, Aditya Birla Nuvo is getting valued at 1,362, which is a good 200 rupee lower than what the, you know, where the stock closed at 1,562, which means from the current market price, there could be a downside of 13%. The swap ratio, which is currently there, that's 100:30. 100 shares of Aditya Birla Nuvo equals to 30 shares of Grasim, values Aditya Birla at 1,362, lower than the current market price of 1,562. Prashant, you wanted to come in?
No,
on that?
You know, I just wanted to ask Mr. Tulsiyan. Mr. Tulsiyan, once the merger is done, is it possible that, so the, I mean, you know, first of all, the hurdle of minority shareholders has to be crossed. But existing shareholders of Grasim, if they are shortchanged, you know, the promoters will say, once the, when the demerger happens, you know, obviously the shareholders of the merged entity, which includes existing Grasim shareholders, will get shares and interest in the financial services business as well, which goes out. So in a way, we are, you know, the logic is going to be, okay, you're going to get compensated.
Yeah.
You're going to get a stake in a fast-growing financial services business. Do you think that makes
Prashant,
sense?
Prashant, I understood your point. Let me first correct here of the Rima's point, you know.
Okay.
If you take the closing price of Aditya Birla Nuvo, it was 1580. And if you take 10 shares are converted into 3 shares of Grasim. 10 shares gives you a value of 15,800. If I take the Grasim valuation 45 to 25, it gives me an effective valuation of 13,575. So obviously, there will be heartbreak on part of the Aditya Birla Nuvo shareholders also, even at the today's current price, that 15,800 are getting converted into 13,575, number one. Number two, your second point that the Grasim shareholders should feel happy.
No, no, I'm not saying should feel happy. I'm saying, you know, it's
happy,
like a...
Happy means maybe, Prashant, because the, you said that the financial services will get demerged, and again the share of that financial services will be given to the Grasim shareholder.
Yes, yes.
But that is a post step. The first step is that first you are getting merged into Grasim, where you yourself is not very happy.
Yes.
And again, take for instance, whatever is the market price tomorrow, and if that demerger gets announced day after tomorrow for the financial services, the share will go X even at the Grasim level. Suppose if I presume that the share, I'm trying to give you the answer to your query, if suppose the Grasim share remains at a price of 4600 tomorrow also, or maybe for next 1 month, and after 1 month you are announcing the swap ratio, terms of the hiving of the financial services, and the valuation of that financial services business is arrived at 1,000 rupees, so the share price of Grasim will fall to 3600 from 4600, because 1,000 rupees will go X. So that is a consequential, just an arithmetical adjustment. No value accretion will be seen, you know, getting accrued to the Grasim shareholder post this merger, because that is just, as I said, it's like a bonus and split adjustment. So whatever effect has to come will be seen tomorrow or maybe in the near time, in the next 1 week, I think market will take its time to accept this move, how damaging or how beneficial it is for the shareholders of Grasim. Because now everything will revolve around the Grasim. Because in my view, Grasim will correct tomorrow. So I won't be surprised to see Aditya Birla Nuvo correcting by 10% at least tomorrow itself. The maximum fall will be seen tomorrow in Aditya Birla Nuvo, then Grasim. Though I'm keeping a negative view on both. But if you want me to stick my neck out, maybe 10% fall in Aditya Birla Nuvo tomorrow and 2 to 3% fall in Grasim tomorrow.
So this Grasim will be corrected about 10-20% in the last two trading sessions. The point I was making about, in a way, not throwing a bone, but essentially luring minorities by saying that you're going to have interest in a fast-growing financial services firm at a later point, right? Whenever the demerger of the merged entity happens. So, I mean, I think that would be the logic that the promoters would use to kind of get minorities, and especially as Mr. Tulsian also said, institutions on their side to first of all say yes on the deal. Because, I mean, unless the majority of minorities say yes to the deal, this ain't happening.
Which could explain why they're first doing the merger and then the
demerger. Merger and then the demerger. So it kind of sort of makes sense. But I think... as we've been saying, and if you're just joining us, what's happened essentially is that the announcement has come. Aditya Birla Nuvo is going to get merged into Grasim. And then from the merged entity, the financial services business is going to go out into a separate entity, which is being called Aditya Birla Financial Services. And that company, the financial services company, will be listed separately in the hope that will realize a much higher value. Those are shots coming in of Mr. Kumar Mangalam Birla. That's the live press conference, which is about to begin at this point in time.
I think we can go across Subhi Upadhyay. She's really spoken to a senior accounting executive on the nitty-gritties of this merger. Subhi, please fill us in.
Okay, guys, I can't hear. Some very, very important clarifications on the critical million-dollar question in this deal. What happens to the debt when you consolidate everything under Grasim? In fact, what I've been given to understand, and I've been talking to some very senior accounting people, is 30% is the cutoff. The deal has been structured in such a way that right now, Grasim will own 28% of Idea, 23% with Aditya Birla Nuovo, and 5% of their existing holding. That is still below the 30% cutoff, which under Ind AS does not have to be consolidated. So the person that I spoke to is a very, very senior person. He's a veteran within the corporate sector, and he's been analyzing deals like this one. He didn't want to come on camera and clearly talk about it, but what we're given to understand is that under Ind AS, since the cutoff is less than 30%, the consolidated balance sheet of Grasim will perhaps not be saddled with Idea's debt. However, there is a big, big if, and that big if is management control. The managements are still similar, the promoter groups are still similar, and those are the intricate, granular details that need to be worked out, because therein questions can arise that in that case, since the management and the promoter group is absolutely similar, will you have to consolidate?
All right, thanks so much for that, Surbhi, but I think we can hop across to the Birla management.
A significant restructuring scheme, and I'll take you through the highlights of that. My colleagues on the dais will then take you through the details. No one here really needs an introduction, but for the sake of good order, Pinky is CFO of Nuvo. Lalit is Managing Director of Nuvo. Sushil is the Group CFO. On my left, Dilip is MD of Grasim. And Ajay is the Business Director for the Financial Services business. So what has been approved by the boards of Nuvo and Grasim essentially is that Nuvo will merge into Grasim. And as a result of the restructuring plan, and it's fairly complex, so I'll leave that to Sushil to explain in more detail. The financial services business today under Nuvo will get listed with about 57% of its shareholding being held by the new Grasim. I call it new Grasim. And the balance being held by the shareholders of Grasim and Nuvo today. So Nuvo gets merged into Grasim. With it moves the 100% sub of, which is the ABFSL, which is a holdco of our financial services business. So the 100% sub of Grasim, which is ABFSL, moves along with, of Nuvo, moves along with Nuvo, becomes 100% sub, therefore, of Grasim Nuco. And as part of the scheme, the financial services business the holding company of the financial services business gets listed with 57% of the shareholding with Grasim, New Grasim, and the balance with the shareholders of Grasim and Nuvo. So that's the overall construct of the structure. So just to talk very briefly about it, I believe this is really a play on the India growth story. So what you have coming through is a very interesting set of businesses, some on the manufacturing space, some in the services space, some which are fast growing, others which are more stable and are throwing out cash. So it's a very good mix of businesses that really are, in a sense, a slice of India, a slice of what the Indian economy today is all about. So you have, for example, cement, you have Visco staple fiber, you have VFI from Nuvo that becomes part of the new Grasim. You have chemicals, which today is part of Grasim. You have fertilizers. On the services businesses side, you've got the financial services array. You've got IDEA, which both of which I think you know about. So a very interesting mix of businesses, strong play on the India growth story, an interesting mix of both mature and fast-growing businesses, some of which are generating cash, and some others which are high-growth businesses. Important thing here, stable cash flow. So you've got a couple of businesses that are generating good cash flows on a regular, ongoing basis. For example, cement, VSF, VFI, chemicals, which is basically caustic soda. As a result of this, like I said, the construct of this restructuring exercise basically unlocks value for shareholders by listing the financial services holdco, which is a huge plus for both sets of shareholders involved in this transaction. It also simplifies group ownership. So, for example, both Nuvo and Grasim have shareholding in Hindalco, in ABFRL, and in IDEA, and that comes together under Grasim New Grasim. So there is simplification of cross-holding that happens. Similar businesses come together. So for example, VFI in Nuvo comes into Grasim along with the other textile business of Grasim, largely VSF and fabric. Caustic soda, you have caustic in both companies, in Nuvo and in Grasim, and they come together, though they are in different geographies, so there's a good fit. What does the new company, New Grasim, look like? So if you see the financials, obviously it's a much larger company which will have a much higher free float, much larger in terms of market cap. Just at a broad level, about 60,000 crores in revenue, EBITDA of about 11,000 crores, and PAT of about 4,000 crores. So considerably larger in terms of just the sheer numbers. And like I said, what you see is a very interesting swath of businesses. 68% of revenue from manufacturing businesses, which essentially is cement, textiles, chemicals, insulators. Solar is only now just being incubated. 32% from service businesses, two large businesses on the services side, IDEA and financial services. And if you look at the pie, if you look at the pie chart, about more than 70% of revenue actually comes from the three fastest growing businesses, which is financial services, telecom, and cement. And I believe that this share will keep going up, going out into the future. So making up a new blue chip, strong financially, just to give you a sense, net debt to EBITDA 0.6, less than 1, net debt to equity of 0.07, interest cover at a very solid 9 times. Businesses where we are deeply entrenched. So we've nurtured these businesses over many years. In most of these businesses, we have a strong leadership position, which is quite unusual for a conglomerate with such a host of businesses to be a market leader across almost every business. And like I said, an interesting mix of businesses, some that are more stable, more that have plateaued in terms of growth but are throwing up cash, others which are much faster growing. A large asset base and well capitalized and strong balance sheet. So that's a very sort of broad brush on the transaction. And I'm going to request Sushil to take us through the transaction and the rationale in some more detail.
Thank you, Mr. Birla. So what I'll do is I'll take you through a little detail of the transaction. So as you know, the Grasim currently has three different segments of the business. One is the cement business. They have a viscose pulp and fiber business and chemical business and part of the textile. And they also have certain investments in various group listed companies. If you look at Nuvo, which is a premier conglomerate having a largest financial services underneath, which is held through a 100% sub of Nuvo, which is called Aditya Birla Financial Services. It also has a life insurance company, which is directly held by Nuvo, and there are stake in payment bank, and there is a financial services business, which is part of a division as a Nuvo. It has its own cash flow business like textile, rayon, insulator, chemical, and some of those other businesses. And it also has an investment in ABFRL, Hindalco, some of the group listed companies. So if we, as Mr. Birla has explained, the first part of the transaction is where Nuvo kind of gets merged into Grasim, which will result into all the financial services company comes together. There is a consolidation of the financial services business, and there is a remaining pure play like Ultratech Cement, Idea Cellular, which gets consolidated, and some of the listed company shares in Hindalco and fashion company gets accumulated. And then there are businesses like textile, chemical, which is common in both the companies, gets kind of consolidated at one place. What also it does is when we are putting consolidating all the financial services business by virtue of demerger, there is a listed the financial services company gets listed, where the shareholders of Grasim and Nuvo will hold around 17% by the promoter, 26% by the public, and 57% by Grasim, new Grasim on a consolidated basis. From a swap ratio, we had a Pricewaterhouse and Bansi S. Mehta who has did our valuation. And on that basis, there is a 3 equity shares of Grasim. So just to explain, if someone is holding 100 shares of Nuvo, they'll get 30 shares of Grasim. And by demerging the financial services business, which will become listed company, will also get 7 shares against 1 shares of ABFSL, which they will get on a post-Grasim situation. So eventually, the 100 shares of Nuvo will result into 30 shares of Grasim and 200 shares of financial services business. That's for the Nuvo shareholders. And for the Grasim shareholders, they'll continue to kind of hold 100 shares of Grasim, and they'll also get additional 700 shares of financial services business. So that's what it comes for both the shareholders. Post-merger, Grasim, as I said, will have 5 different business lines. In each of these business lines, there is a leadership position. Financial services, we currently manage around $29 million US dollar AUM. We have 12 different business lines within financial services space. In our life insurance business and asset management business, we are fourth in the ranking of the business, and we have a fastest growing non-bank finance company in the country, where we have assets of around 30,000 crores. Telecom, as you know, we are third largest player in India. We also own 16% in world's largest tower company. Cement, as you know, we are largest in the country. Textile, we are a global player. We have a leading linen manufacturing businesses. And chemical business, again, we are the largest at the country level. Number, as Mr. Birla was explaining, at a revenue level, post-merger, we'll have a close to $9 billion kind of revenue. and we'll have a healthy EBITDA of around 12,000 crores. What is important to note that the EBITDA margin is around 19%. And for Grasim shareholders, we are actually getting a high growth EBITDA business to Grasim shareholders. From a transaction point of view, we have Merrill Lynch, who is advisor on the transaction. We have a two independent fairness opinion from JM Financial and Kotak Mahindra. JM was advising Grasim, and Kotak Mahindra was advising Nuvo. We had a joint independent valuer, as I said, Pricewaterhouse and Bansi S. Mehta. And from a legal point of view, we had a Khaitan & Company advising on the transaction, and Cyril Amarchand Mangal Das for financial services business. I'll request Ajay to kind of take you through on financial services business in a little more detail.
Good evening. Can you hear me at the back there? Okay, cool. So over the next few slides, I just thought I'll give you a sense of the financial services business. I have three or four slides to give you a sense of some of the individual businesses and some aggregate numbers. But let me first start with giving you a sense of what the new entity, demerged entity, will look like. So the shareholding, as you can see from the chart, shareholding would be 17% would be held by the promoters, 57% by Grasim itself, 26% by the public. That would be a holding in Aditya Birla Financial Services, which is a holding company for all of financial services. The businesses that sit underneath that that holding company are some very diversified businesses. So you can see we have an NBFC, we have a life insurance company, we are a 51% holder in the payments bank, we have an asset management company, a housing finance company, a health insurance company, and then several other businesses, as you can see on the right-hand side of that box, a broking business, an insurance, general insurance advisory business, a private equity business, and an online money management business. So I think what really makes ABFS quite unique in the market is the diversification that we have amongst in the businesses that we have. So we are a very diversified financial services company, and not just in terms of breadth, but I think if you look at the size that we've built in each of these businesses, we build scale across the platform. And that's what the right-hand side of the chart really talks about. We're amongst the top five fund managers in India. We manage just under 2 lakh crores of assets under management across our life insurance business, our asset management business, and our private equity business. Our lending book through our NBFC and our housing finance business is about 28,700 crores. We're amongst the top 10 diversified private NBFCs in the country. We're amongst the top 4 in both the life insurance space and the asset management space. We're the number one online personal financial management company in India. And through the network and through the platform, we serve 8.8 million customers, have a nationwide presence with 1,350 points of presence, and working through 120,000 channel partners. So as I said at the beginning, I think this is really a very diversified financial services business, which has built scale in each one of the businesses in which we operate. If I look at the next slide, I'll just walk you through 4 key metrics that we think are quite important from a financial services standpoint. The first is assets under management, and if we look at the growth from 2011 to 2016, you can see we've grown over 2 times. We've more than doubled our assets under management in this period. So we ended last year with 1,84,000 crores of assets under management, and as I just mentioned to you, if I look at the June quarter, we're just under 2 lakh crores in that metric. Our lending book has grown very fast over this period, so it's grown 15 times from 2011 to 2016. Our revenues have grown about 1.5 times to 9,300 crores at the end of FY16, and our profitability grew to just under 1,000 crores in FY16. So as you can see, across all the metrics, we've made considerable progress, built scale, built some materiality across the platform. If I just now walk you through a couple of our, I'll walk you through 2 or 3 of our large businesses and give you a flavor of some of the other businesses that we have. So if you look at our NBFC, as I said earlier, we're amongst the top 10 diversified private NBFCs in India. We have a diversified portfolio. We operate in the loan against securities space. We operate in the loan against properties, lease rent discounting, home finance, SME finance, structured finance, really a diversified book across the NBFC. But I think what is more interesting is alongside the growth that we've seen in the past, I talked to you about the rapid growth in the NBFC, we've been able to maintain the credit quality in our book. So our net NPA as of FY16 was 0.22%. And if you look at the first quarter, it's 0.29%. So we've really been able to keep a very tight control on credit costs and the quality of the book. Our net worth as of June 30th was 3,823 crores under Indian GAAP. And all of you know that these businesses are valued typically at a multiple to book. So you can impute what the market multiples are. Typically, market multiples are 3 to 3.5 times book. So you'll get a sense of what the NBFC could be worth. Our loan book, as I said, at the end of June 30th was about 26,300 crores. It's a AA+ rating for the NBFC. Moving to the asset management business, we are the fourth largest asset manager in India. As of the Q1 of FY17, our assets under management, average assets under management were 1,63,000 crores. We've been consistently outperforming the industry, gaining market share. So as you can see on the chart below in terms of market share, whether it's equity or debt, we've gained market share from FY11. FY11, our equity market share was 5.5%. FY16, our market share is 7.6%. In debt, our market share was 10.6% in FY11. Now we're talking about 11.7% market share in debt itself. Our asset management company has a multi-channel distribution, and it has top quality fund performance across all asset classes. Whether it's hybrid, equity, or fixed income, we're amongst the top performers in the categories in which we operate. This business typically works as a percentage of AUM in terms of valuation, and typical transactions have happened between 5 to 7%. So again, you can impute what the value of this business might be. If I move on to our life insurance business, we are a top four private player in our life insurance business, market share of about 8.4% in the first quarter of this year. We're number one in the group business, where we have a 25% market share, so we're clearly large players in that segment. Again, we have multi-channel distribution. About 3/4 of our business comes from agency. The balance comes from third-party distribution, both brokers and banker. We have a diversified product portfolio across traditional products, PAR, non-PAR, and ULIP products. And our embedded value as of March 16 was 3,275 crores. We had a VNB margin of 15.2%. Again, these businesses are typically multiplied, valued as a multiple of EV. Recent transactions have happened anywhere between 2.5 to 3 times EV. So you'll get a sense of, you know, what this business could be worth. Some of the other businesses in the portfolio, newer businesses that are growing, Aditya Birla Housing Finance was only set up in October 2014. Today has a loan book of 2,432 crores in a fairly short period of time, a net worth of just under 300 crores. So again, this is a multiple of book valuation business. Aditya Birla Insurance Brokers is a general insurance broking business, placed about 1,600 crores of premium last year, has consistently gained market share. We have just under 2% market share in this business, which is a fairly fragmented business in the market. We have a private equity business, manage about 1,000 crores in private equity. We've just got approval from the regulators to launch our health insurance business, which will go live in the second half of this fiscal year. It's a joint venture with MMI of South Africa, one of the leading players in that market. We have a broking and wealth management business under the brand Aditya Birla Money. My Universe is actually a very interesting, exciting business we have in our fold. It's an online personal finance management portal. It basically allows customers to come on board, aggregate their financial information, get advice, and transact. We have 2.7 million customers operating through this platform today, managing about 20,000 crores of their money on this platform. So really, opportunity for us to make a multi-product distribution platform through this, acquire a large number of customers, and cross-sell across the platform. And last, I'll just mention the Payments Bank, which is a 51-49 joint venture between financial services and IDEA. Great opportunity for us to use the telecom network to really distribute financial services products through the length and breadth of this country. IDEA has an absolutely phenomenal network of retailers across the country and a very large subscriber base, 183 million subscribers. So if we're able to leverage that subscriber base and distribute financial services products to them, you know, then I think we're talking about a very, very different opportunity compared to where we are today. I'll hand back to Sushil to conclude this presentation.
So as I said earlier, basically what we believe this transaction does is it's a win-win for both sets of shareholders, for Nuvo shareholders and Grasim shareholders. For Grasim shareholders, it gives them an exposure to two fast-growing sectors, which is financial services and telecom, which they didn't have this far. Several other businesses, for example, VFI, insulators, where we have a leadership position. These are businesses that we've nurtured over many years, businesses that we understand very well. So the long horizon of growth For Nuvo shareholders, I believe two very strong businesses generating cash, cement and VFI. Large capitalization with better liquidity, that goes without saying. You also have access to the fund flow of two strong businesses, cement and VSF, to actually grow the financial services businesses, something that would have been difficult under the existing structure of being a subsidiary of Nuvo. Common benefits for both sets of shareholders, like I said, the financial services business gets listed, and the shareholders of new Grasim, which means the shareholders of current Grasim and Nuvo, get shares directly in the listed FinCo. Clearly a benefit for both sets of shareholders. Simplifies group structures because both companies have shareholding today in some operating opcos of the group, Hindalco, APFRL, IDEA. All of those get consolidated. Similar businesses, like I said, under the broad umbrella of textiles. So VFI from Nuvo goes into Grasim, which also has textile and VSF, more importantly. Both businesses, both companies have caustic, which come together. And I think also very importantly, investors can decide whether they want to be invested in Grasim or in any of the opcos directly. So whether it's IDEA or financial services, that's an option that a shareholder or an investor always has. So that is an overview. I think that's a fairly in-depth overview of the transaction that the boards have approved today. We'd be happy to take questions. I'll take the simpler ones and pass on the difficult ones.